Hello everyone, welcome to CommerceNet Scholars. I hope you all are perfectly fit and fine and you are being regular with the studies. In today's video, we'll be discussing about the meaning of assignment and nomination. At the same time, we'll understand what is the basic difference between the two, what are the different criterions on which both are different from each other. So let's start with today's video and first understand the meaning of assignment and nomination. Talking about assignment and nomination, let's first understand the term nomination, as you must be quite familiar with this term. This is something very common that you must have come across whenever you're opening a bank account or someone else has opened a bank account, maybe your father or your mother. You have opened your bank account, whatever bank details you need to fill upon, you also need to mention the name of the nominee. Nominee will be the person who will be entitled to receive the payment in case you are no more. The bank, whatever funds are there in the bank account, will be transferred to the nominee whom you have assigned as the nominee. Now again, for making a person nominee, you must have some blood relationship or a legal relationship with that person. You cannot nominate your friend as a nominee. Talking about assignment means that you are not only transferring the funds, rather you are transferring the entire contract to the person. In nomination, you are making the person a nominee. Whenever you are taking a life insurance policy and you are assigning a nominee, you are making a person entitled to receive the payment in case you are no more, in case you are not surviving. But in case of assignment, when you are assigning the policy to someone, you are giving the charge of that particular contract, of that particular policy, to the person whom you have assigned the contract. So now let's understand the basic differences between assignment and nomination. Talking about the first difference, it states nomination can be done even before the issue of policy by mentioning the nominee's name, address, relationship, etc. in the proposal form. Talking about nomination before the issue of the policy, this point needs to be understood clearly. Even before you have even before the policy has been issued to you. Policy is basically what? We are not talking about you entering into the life insurance contract. We are talking about the document that you receive as policy. Entering into the policy is a different situation, while receiving the policy document is a different situation that you need to understand. Once you receive the policy document, it means that your life insurance has started and you are entitled to receive the compensation. So this procedure of nominating a person for your policy is done even before you get the actual physical form of the policy document. Even before you receive the policy document, you have nominated a person for your policy, because that is a basic criterion while filling all the details while entering into the policy. Suppose a person has taken a policy, a man has taken policy for himself, and he wants to nominate his wife as his nominee. So what the person is going to do, when he'll be filling all the details while taking the insurance policy, he'll be mentioning the name of his wife as a nominee in those particular documents. And after that, once those documents are processed, he will be receiving the policy document in the physical form. Talking about assignment, it is not possible before the issue of the policy, as the life assured did not acquire the property which he can assign. Whenever we are talking about assignment, you cannot assign a policy before you have received it in physical form, before you have received the policy, because this is something you want to transfer it to someone else. Assignment means that you are going to transfer it to someone else. You are giving a task to someone else to carry out that policy for further. So now, whenever we are talking about assignment, you cannot assign a policy until and unless you have received the policy document in the physical form, because only that document makes you eligible enough to transfer it to someone else. Second point says, for nomination, it need not be supported by a consideration. Obviously, if you are assigning someone as a nominee, you do that particular person, the nominee, does not need to pay off any consideration. Talking about life insurance, if you have taken a life insurance policy and you have assigned your wife or your husband as a nominee, so this is not required on the part of your husband or wife to pay the premium. You have taken the policy, you are going to pay the premium. In case you are no more, they will get the amount that they are supposed to. But this does not mean that they are going to pay the premium on your behalf. But talking about assignment, it must be supported by a consideration. That means once you have transferred the policy, it simply means that it is the duty and responsibility of that particular person that he is going to pay the he is going to pay the premium for the remaining time span. Next, witness is not essential. Obviously, whenever you are going for a bank, opening of a bank account, you are entering the details, you don't require a witness with you that see, I have brought so and so witness and the person I am assigning as a nominee is having a blood relationship or legal relationship with me, or you need to make it approved by the bank authorities that yes, I have assigned so and so person as nominee. So because the duties and the roles are not there, the only task of assigning a nominee is that the person is entitled to receive the payment. But in terms, when we are talking about assignee, a witness must be there, because there must be some proof that you have assigned your policy to someone and now that person is required to carry out it for the further time span. Fourth point says, a nominee has no right to sue under the policy. The nominee will be having no right to sue the insurer in case the policy terms and conditions are not met. But in case of assignment, the assignee has the right to sue under the policy, right? Whoever is the assignee, that means to whom the policy has been assigned. The one who is assigning will be the assigner, and to whom it has been assigned will be the assignee. So assignee has the right to sue under the policy if any terms and conditions are not met. Fifth, it can be cancelled by the life assurer during the currency of the policy. While the policy is in force, the person who has got the life insured, in case of nomination, he can cancel the policy. It is into his discretion that what he wants to do further. But talking about assignment, assigner cannot cancel it. Once it has been assigned to someone else, once you have assigned your policy to someone else, you have no right over the policy. Only the assignee can cancel it. Next, assured retains full control and can deal with the policy in whatever manner he likes. He need not take consent of the nominee. If you are owning a bank account, if you are owning an insurance policy, it completely depends on your discretion what decisions you want to take for your policy. You need not consult your nominee, and most of the time the nominee is not even aware that he is the nominee for the policy. This happens most of the time. People are making their children as the nominee, and the children are least aware that they have been, you know, made as a nominee for the life insurance policy of their parents. So whatever decisions have been taken in case of nomination, they are taken by the assured only, who has taken the insurance policy. But talking about assignment, whatever decisions are being taken, they are taken only by the assignee. Once the policy is assigned, the assigner has lost all control over the policy. Seventh, if a nominee is minor, that means below 18 years of age, it is desirable to appoint an appointee on behalf of the minor. Assured makes such appointment. Whenever you are making a person nominee who is a minor, who is below 18 years of age, if a person has made his child a nominee, he will also have to appoint some appointee on behalf of it, that who is going to take care of the amount that is to be given. Most of the times, you people have seen in the movies that there are step mothers or step fathers, and obviously the real father or mother has transferred a lot of property on the name of the son or daughter, and they are waiting for the child to be 18 years of age so that they can kill him or prove him that he is mental or his mental conditions are not good, so that he can have the control over the property. So this is a tragic drama that we see in the movies, but obviously it is something that is related to the real life. Until and unless the person is of 18 years of age, he is not having full control over the amount that he is he is required to get. In case of assignment, when assignee is a minor, guardian is to be appointed by the father of the assignee. Whenever you are assigning a policy to a minor, assigning the policy, you are going to appoint a guardian by the father of the assignee. Assignee will be the person to whom the policy has been assigned. So this guardian will be to whom the policy has been assigned. So this guardian will be appointed by the father of the assignee if the father is incompetent enough to carry forward it for further time span. Next, nominee gets the money on the death of the life insured. This I already told you that nominee will be getting the amount only and only when the person who has taken the actual policy is dead. While in assignment, assignee is the person legally entitled to receive the policy money. Assignee will be the person who can avail the benefits of the compensation either on death or on maturity depending upon the policy. He need not wait for the death of the original person, that is the assigner, for him to die to avail the benefits of the policy. He will get the benefits of the policy at his wish or will depending upon the death or maturity, whichever is earlier, depending again on the terms and conditions of the policy. Next is nomination becomes ineffective at the death of the nominee. Once you have assigned a person as your nominee and that nominee dies, so in that case, nomination becomes ineffective. You have to reappoint someone else as your nominee if your pre-existing nominee is no more in the world. This you need to remember. While talking about assignment, if an absolute assignee dies, the right dissolves upon his or her heirs. That means whenever the person who has taken the assignment, who has availed the assignment of the policy, the assignee, if the assignee is dead, whoever is the legal representative of that person, he will be carrying it forward for the further time span. It won't come to an end. If they want to continue, if they wish to continue, they can continue it for further time span. While in case of nomination, if the nominee is dead, you need to reappoint a nominee for your life insurance policy. So I just hope the difference between nomination and assignment is really clear to you all. This topic is really important for our upcoming topics that we'll be doing, that is the policy conditions. So that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.